Today we'll start with different types of pricing. Okay, so the different companies usually use different methods of pricing. Okay, so for example, I'm company A, I'll use one strategy of pricing. Company B will use another strategy of pricing. Why so? First of all, the companies differ in their products. Okay, supposedly I am selling in maybe Classmate copies, another company selling for maybe Apple iPhones. Okay, so our product is different, so our pricing strategy will be different. Next, another consideration is that target market. Supposedly when I am selling Classmate copies, my target market would be mass marketing. Like I want to target everyone, as much as I want to reach out, it's good for me. For iPhone companies, it will be like specified market, only high-end customers, right? So target market is another consideration for to decide on pricing. So while we take this two pillar into consideration, before we consider pricing or before we consider different strategies of pricing, first, the companies have to know what is the type of the product. Second, the companies have to be aware about the fact that in which market that they want to target. Once they got this two answer, and finally, they can keep their or they can make their pricing strategy. The first strategy that we have is penetration pricing strategy. So, as I have discussed last day, I have given you a brief about penetration pricing strategy. What is penetration pricing strategy? As you can see here, it is low to high. What do you mean by this? This is, first, penetration pricing strategy is a very, very commonly used pricing strategy. Like most of the marketers, most of the companies usually go for this pricing strategy. Why? Penetration pricing strategy is such a strategy, once any company want to enter in the market, once they are in the introduction stage or once they want to enter in the market, they adopt this kind of strategy. What is this strategy? Once they want to enter in the market, they'll first keep the price to be very, very low, and once they have captured the market, slowly, slowly they'll increase the price. We can think of an example, maybe like Mi phones. Three and a half years back, just let's recall what would be the price of Mi phones. It was pretty less, right? Today, Mi phones are pretty at maybe affordable price, but it is not less anymore. So once they want to, three and a half years back, once they wanted to reach out to the market, they kept the price very low compared to that of Samsung or any other good companies. But now, once they know that they have captured the market, they have captured a good market, they are slowly adding some features to it and increasing the price of it. Okay, so what we can know is that the key point what I have highlighted is the goods and services are priced lower than those of competitors. Whatever my competitor's price will be, I have to keep low to that, like less than that. Whatever my competitor's price will be, I have to keep less than my competitor's price. So once I keep less than my competitor's price, of course, customers, we know that they are price sensitive. Wherever they'll see that, okay, I'm getting the same feature but at lesser price, they'll opt for that product. That is why these strategies are used. These strategies can be used for consumer durables. These strategies can be used for mobile companies. These strategies are mostly used by all type of products. So this is a very commonly used strategy. First, once you entered into the market, you keep the price low. Once you have a good market, or maybe once you have captured a good market, then you slowly increase your price. Okay, first, at the initial time, they do not want to go for profit. Okay, but later on, once they are increasing the price, they want to look for profit. Next pricing strategy, number two that we have here, is skimming pricing. What is skimming pricing? Skimming pricing is when the price is kept very high. This is just opposite to penetration pricing. So any companies that want to enter into the market, they are here not going for mass marketing. Here they are going for target specific market, okay, or a specified market that they want to target only some customers. So if we take an example of Apple iPhone, okay? So once we take an example of Apple iPhone, what we can see, supposedly Apple iPhone wants to launch in the market. So what will they do? They won't keep the price low. So they will keep the price high initially because they know that I want this iPhone 11 Pro to be with people who are high-end customers and not with everyone, right? So they'll keep the price very, very high. Once maybe after 1.5 years, after 2 years, they'll reduce the price. That's what we have seen the strategy for Apple to be. So skimming pricing is somewhat like that. They'll keep hype. Once they enter into the market, they'll keep the price to be high. Once they have like maybe they have attained their goal, then slowly they'll reduce the price. Okay, so why would they reduce the price? They would allow the competitors to come in and maybe to compete in the market. Initially they didn't want any competitors, they didn't want to compete in the market, but now slowly they want to compete in the market. Okay, that is the reason they would go for skimming pricing. So for example, for penetration pricing we can take example for MI phones, for skimming pricing we can take example of Apple iPhones. The next strategy that we have is odd pricing or psychological pricing. We all know about this pricing, okay? This is an amazing pricing technology that is being used by many companies nowadays. But firstly, it was used by Bata. Okay, we all are aware about this Bata shoe company. First, this technique was used by Bata. What is this technique? Imagine for a second. Okay, let's quickly imagine for a second. We went to buy maybe a mobile cover. Okay, so now when we went to buy a mobile cover, we see at one place, at one rack, it is written 199, and in another rack, it is written 200. Okay, so once we see, first and the foremost thing that we'll go, we know that it is 199, it is 200. But usually the customer mind is such, the initial beginning is from 1. And there the initial beginning is from 2. Because 200 starts with 2, 199 starts with 1. The customer, the maximum of the customers will go and check at 199. Okay, the difference, if we think logically, oh, it's just a matter of 1 rupees, but it is about customers' attraction. So this 199, 299, 399, this 99, it sounds better than maybe the actual numbers or the whole numbers. This 199 will sound better to you than 200, okay? Or maybe it will look better to you than 200. That's why this pricing technology is used. This is called psychological pricing and odd pricing. A product having an odd number, 249, instead of 250, 249. You will go and buy the product which is 249 and not 250. So this is my odd pricing or psychological pricing. This plays with consumer's mind that I am giving you 1 rupees less, but I am paying you a lot more in that money. Okay, he is keeping 250 rupees, I am keeping 249, I am giving you a lot more. Okay, so this is how they play with your minds, or this is how they play with our minds. So this is called psychological pricing. Next pricing method that we have is called prestige pricing. So what is this prestige pricing? This is usually used for luxury goods, okay? So how do we use this luxury goods? Supposedly, marketers will keep high price, okay? For some products, the marketers will keep high price. For example, let's take an example of Zara, okay? We know usually the price of Zara perfumes. Let's take an example for men and women both. The price of Zara perfume is high compared to normal XYZ brand, okay? Or maybe for example, we take Tommy Hilfiger, okay? All these brands, we know that the price will be high. But even if we know that the prices are high, we go and buy the product. Why? The Zara perfume may be very similar, like I don't want to hurt the sentiment of Zara users at all, but the Zara perfume may be the smell may be very, very similar to Engage smell, okay, just for example, but we'll still pay maybe 200, 500 rupees extra in Zara perfume and we'll go and buy that. Why? Because we know we are paying 600 rupees for that Zara perfume. It is bound to give me a good quality. Okay, so we have a tendency of judging the product on the basis of price. The moment we see our parents, or maybe for us also, supposedly I'll keep 2 pens, okay, with absolutely only price tags and not with any brand name. Just imagine I'm keeping 2 pens, okay. One pen is for 100 rupees and another pen price is for 500 rupees, okay. So I am not putting any brand name, I'm not putting any tag, I'm just giving 100 rupees and 500 rupees. Okay, so what will be the first thing that will come to your mind? Just quickly, let's think what will be the first thing that will come to the mind. The 500 rupees one is more valuable, it will be more long lasting, the nib will be amazing, and it will be good to write with this pen. The 500 one, it just costs 500, it has to be good. So we have this tendency, okay. So prestige pricing is also somewhat like that. The customer has a tendency to judge the quality by the price. The moment it is 100, you know, acha ye to chalega, ye to kuch din chalega, uske baad to theek hai, matlab normal, phek dena padega. But the 500 rupees, you know, oh, I'm paying 500 rupees, at least ye to ek saal chalega. But maybe even the, if I remove, why did I remove all the brand name, the tags and everything? Because I have kept 2 pens that were exactly identical. Just with the help of price tags, we get to judge the value of the, or maybe the quality of the pen. So this is what prestige pricing is. Whenever for luxury goods also, for everything, okay? So the moment we see Tommy Hilfiger, we see the brand Tommy Hilfiger and we pay 3000 rupees maybe for one top or maybe for one t-shirt. We get to pay this because we know, oh, Tommy, this will give me a good quality. Maybe that same quality you will get in maybe a normal brand, maybe a normal Vero Moda brand or any kind of a normal brand you will get it. But you know, the moment the tag is given Tommy, or moment you're paying 3000 rupees, you know, oh, this shirt or this t-shirt quality is going to be amazing. This is what prestige pricing is, okay? The next pricing we have is bundle pricing. We often come across this bundle pricing a lot many times. Supposedly, we are going for a restaurant, okay? Supposedly, any of the restaurant we go, you go on a Wednesday evening, okay? They tell you, supposedly, your minimum bill should be 2000, then you get 2 cold coffee free. So you will try to push yourself to that extent so that your bill reach to 2000 rupees, because you want to offer, you want to avail that offer, which that you get 2 cold coffees free. This is normal human tendency. So even you take an example of Pantaloons, you take an example of Shoppers Stop, you take any example, whenever they tell you minimum shopping of 2000 will give you a voucher of 500 rupees. So they are pushing you to buy the product for 2000 rupees so that again they'll give you a voucher of 1000 and you spend 1000 in that again, okay, in that specific brand. So bundle pricing, one is this category of bundle pricing. Another bundle pricing is when you see maybe with a Sunsilk shampoo, once you're buying a Sunsilk shampoo, you get a small conditioner free, okay? So what is two multiple products, okay? You either you lower down the price of the two multiple products, or the Sunsilk shampoo with the conditioner, if they are bundled together, maybe individually the Sunsilk shampoo will be 100 and the conditioner will be 70. So individually it should have been 170, but once they have put down both in one frame, that is the shampoo and the conditioner together in one box, they are charging you 140 rupees. So you know that you are saving out 30 rupees. So this is what bundle pricing is. They are pushing you to buy both the products but at lesser price, okay? So this is what bundle pricing is. The next pricing strategy is price discrimination, okay? This once I have already explained you what is price discrimination, still I'm going to tell you. So often we see we are being charged different price for the same product. Supposedly I'm a daily user of some product, maybe supposedly for a kirana store, okay? So the moment you go to the kirana store, if the kirana person or the person who is selling, if he knows you, he will give you at first, or maybe he'll give you 2 rupees discount. Maybe for a packet of chips, he'll sell you at, if you're buying 10 packets every day, he'll give you maybe 10 rupees discount. Okay, chalo, take this as free, or maybe I'll give you some kind of discount. Whereas if I'm a new customer of that kirana store, he won't give me that. So often we see this, that there are different prices are charged for same category of product. This is called price discrimination. First of all, it can happen because of some ages, like supposedly banking service, okay? The rate of interest for maybe if we are keeping money in the bank, for example, okay? Once we are keeping money in the bank, the rate of interest we are getting, that is you and me is getting, is much lower than the rate of interest the person with 60 plus age is getting. Okay, so why is this? But the same product, right? We are keeping the same money, but why? To provide them with some kind of benefit. This is price discrimination. Okay, that for the same product, when we are charged differently, it can be because of the location, right? So for example, again, woolen sweater, okay? So if I'm talking about a woolen sweater or any kind, if I'm talking about a sweater from in the Ludhiana market, when you go and buy a sweater in the Ludhiana market, it will be around 200 rupees. A very good quality sweater, it will be around 200 rupees. The moment you come and get it from Park Street, or the moment you come and get it from any kind of store in Kolkata, it will be 700 rupees. Same product, but due to location difference, okay, you are being charged differently. So this is called price differentiation. It can be because of the type of buyer, it can be because of different location, it can be because of different age, anything, but when you are charging differently for same product is price discrimination. Next, number 7 is price leadership. So in an oligopolistic market or in an oligopolistic business, you see the dominant competitors, like they lead their way. So how is it? How do we go about it? Supposedly today, Maggi. Okay, so Maggi in that category of product, Maggi, Top Ramen, YY, Maggi is the leader, we can say, right? The moment we see that Maggi was giving an advertisement, okay, the moment Maggi is giving an advertisement, we see Top Ramen will give one or two advertisements in the TV or maybe in the radio and all of that. YY will also give advertisement. Yuppie will also give advertisement, right? Similarly, once they want to compete in the market, like, okay, I am at par with you, they try to keep the price also very similar to that. Okay, for example, Complan and Horlicks. The moment Complan will reduce the price, maybe from 100 rupees to 90 rupees, Horlicks is bound to reduce the price from 110 rupees to 100 rupees, maybe. Okay, or the moment Complan is increasing the price from 100 to 110 rupees, supposedly Complan is increasing the price from 100 to 110 rupees, Horlicks will also increase the price from 110 rupees to 120 rupees. So it is like an oligopolistic business. Whatever my dominant competitors will do, I tend to follow that. Either I decrease the price because my price leader is doing that, okay, or my market leader is doing that, or I increase the price because my market leader is doing that. So I tend to immediately follow what my leader is doing. So this is price leadership. What I get to follow what my leader is doing, and accordingly I fix up the price. Next one is going rate pricing. Going rate pricing is a usual common pricing strategy. Going rate pricing is very similar to price leadership. What happens in going rate pricing is that whatever is your competitors are keeping the price to be, you keep the price very similar to that. You don't follow what your leader is only doing, but whatever your other competitors are keeping the price to be, you keep a price very, very similar to that. This can be taken an example for pens, okay? Whenever we see different pen companies, or whenever see any cosmetics companies and all of that, we see Maybelline, Lakme, all Faces, Services and all of this company will keep their cosmetics price to be at par with each other. Okay, so whatever my competitors are keeping the price to be, I'll keep the price very similar to that. That is my going rate pricing. Next one that we have is sealed bid price. So in sealed bid pricing, what happens? This is a not very common method nowadays. Previously, one or two companies used to adopt this, but this is a very tedious method, so people do not use this method. So what happens for maybe large contracts, okay, or for large orders, what will happen? The industry buyers, okay, or maybe the government department, what will they do? They'll tend to buy supposedly for maybe some parts of engines for maybe trains, okay. So what will happen? 2-3 sellers will come down and tell you, okay, you please buy from me, the government. So what will they do? They'll seal the price, or they'll seal the bid of the price, that okay, I'll give you at this price. Another company B is coming and telling you, sealing it and keeping it the price, okay, I'm giving you to at this price. And another company C is coming and telling you, okay, I'm sealing it and giving it at this price. No one knows what others have kept the price to be, okay. So now, with the help of, now the government official will open all the seal, and whichever is the lower one, they'll pick up that. Okay, so this is like a very tedious method, so people nowadays do not go for this kind of pricing. Next one is the perceived value pricing. Perceived value pricing is a common technique that is used. So this is usually for new products, okay. So when I told you an example of Pulse in the market, a good market survey was done before Pulse was launched in the market. So people were asked, like, if I'm giving you this product, please taste my product, what you feel should be the price of the product. So perceived value pricing is, the moment we use the product or moment we consume the product, we tend to perceive a value of the product. This is maximum I can pay for this product. Not even a penny more than that I can pay for this product. Supposedly I give you a mobile phone without any brand or anything, okay, you're using that mobile phones with all the software, the camera, the RAM and everything, you are checking it, okay. So once you are checking all of that, you will have a perceived value of the pricing. Okay, with this features, I think the value or the price can be maybe 14,000, the price can be 20,000. So the cost, now the marketers will take reviews from n numbers of customers like this, okay, like he will ask 100 of customers like this. So the range that they'll get, 14,000 to 16,000, accordingly they'll keep the price of the product. So supposedly I am telling that this price, according to this mobile phones that you have manufactured, the price can be 14,000. Now another friend of mine is telling it to be 15,000, another friend of mine is telling it to be 16,000. So I either take an average of all of these and take a price, or the maximum people, what is the maximum people deriving? Some people can say 20,000, but the maximum people are saying the price range can be of 14,000, 15,000 and 16,000. So I keep the price of this mobile phone to be 15,000, because maximum people was perceiving the value of this mobile phones to be more, not more than 15,000, somewhere between 15,000 to 20,000. So I chose to keep the price of the product to be 15,000. So the consumers is being asked, or the whatever the consumers are perceiving the value of the product to be, accordingly the prices of the product are set. So now it all depends on the consumers. The consumers are being left with the product, whatever they are perceiving the value of the product to be, according after that the price of the products are fixed, okay. So this were the different types of pricing strategies. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, we'll discuss all of these again in the doubt clearing session. Thank you for your class today. Have a nice day.